Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. How to simplify the third root of 10 minus 7 times square root of 2? This is a challenging question. We will discuss a powerful method. Here is the theory. If the third root of a plus b times square root of k, here a, b both are integers. K is a positive integer. If this can be simplified, then we have the following form. This third root equals x plus y times square root of k times the third root of t. Here, for some x and y, both x, y are integers, and t is a rational number. Back to our question. What is a? That's 10. What is b? Negative 2. What is k? Equals 2. We can assume our question equals x plus y times square root of 2, then times the third root of t. The remaining question is how to find integers x and y and rational number t. How to get rid of the third root sign from this equation? Both sides, we can take the third power on both sides. Then we have 10 minus 7 times square root of 2 equals t times x plus y times square root of 2, then to the power 3. The second part, we can use the binomial formula. Or you can use the Pascal triangle to find those coefficients. Here is the detail. Then we group this part into two parts. First part without the square root 2. The second part with the square root of 2. Why are we doing this? We want to compare both sides. What does this mean? This means the left-hand side 10 without square root of 2 should be equal to the first part. Negative 7 with square root of 2 should be this part. In summary, t times x to the power 3 plus 6 times x times y squared equals 10. T times 3x squared y plus 2y to the power 3 equals negative 7. We have two equations here. The first equation divided by second equation. We can cancel t. Cross multiply, we leave negative sign to 10. We are here now. Both side divided by y to the power 3. Now we have x to the power 3 divided by y to the power 3 equals x over y to the power 3. Here's 6, x y squared divided by y to the power 3 equals y over y. Sorry, x over y equals negative 10 times, here's 3, x squared y divided by y to the power 3 equals x over y, then to the power 2. Y to the power 3 divided by y to the power 3 equals 1. This part should be 2. We can consider this equation only has one variable, x over y. We can define a new variable called u. U equals x over y. Replace x over y by u. In this equation, we have 7 times u to the power 3 plus 6u equals negative 10 times 3u squared plus 2. Simplify, we have this equation. This is a third power equation. How to solve this third power equation? What do we want? We want to find x and y. That means we want to find a u. How to find a u? We only need u to be a rational number, not necessary to be an integer. How to solve this equation? There are different methods. Look at this equation. Left-hand side, all plus here. If u is positive, the left-hand side is positive. It is impossible because the right-hand side is zero. This implies u must be negative. To find a rational solution for this third power equation, we can try this. Try all factors of the last constants, 20. Positive, negative, 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, 20. Here we only need to try negative factors. It's not difficult to try to find one solution, one rational solution. It is negative 2. By the way, when you try to finish solving this equation, you will find the other two are irrational solutions. We only have one rational solution. U equals negative 2. U is defined by x over y. This means x over y equals negative 2. So here we can assume x equals 2, y equals negative 1. Why can we do this? If you assume x equals negative 2, y equals positive 1, you will end up with the same solution. The question here is, we only need to find a solution, not all solutions. Next thing we need to do is to find the t. How to find the t? From this equation, we can replace x, y by the two values. Solve this equation to find the t. Plugging x and y into this equation. Continue to simplify. We can find the t equals 1/2. Right now, we have all three numbers for x, y, and t. It's ready to derive the final answer. Just replace x, y, and t by these three numbers. We have this. Continue to simplify. We have the final answer. The third root of 4 minus the sixth root of 2 is the final answer. We'll give you one more question to try. Can you try this? You can use a similar idea from this video. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.